Thank you very much, Bertie Pacheco. Cannot talk about it enough. The United States doctor, Dr. Bob Voy, was in charge of cuts for all the Olympic competition, and after Mai was cut against Montel Griffin, he was removed from his position and replaced by a German doctor. And what was that on Torsten Mai's eye? So Torsten Mai advances to the gold medal bout on Sunday against Rotislav Zolichny of the unified team. And now we move to the super heavyweights.
And Bob, before you announce them, you know, Ferdy is going off to play bulldog right now. He's gonna be the pit bull on this one. He's gonna go over and find out exactly what that was on Torsten Mai's eye. Maybe we'll get some information before this wraps up.
There you get a look at Roberto Bolatto of Cuba, 23 years of age, 1991 world champion. And we'd like to apologize for some of the video problems that we're having. Live boxing action on the Red Channel, and we hope to get everything cleared up for you in a second or two. So just bear with us. Tomislav Popik of Australia is our referee. Roberto Bolatto in the blue. And Brian Nielsen of Denmark in the red. We apologize for our video problems. Bob Popo along with Wally Matthews. Semi-final action from the Juventude Pavilion. We'll get the video problem straightened out as soon as possible. Maybe Ferdy went to go look at the substance on Mai's eye to work out the problems. An aggressive fight doctor. Brian Nielsen of Denmark against Roberto Bolatto of Cuba.
I'll tell you what, I don't know if Nielsen's gonna win this fight, but I know that he will brawl with Bolatto where Larry Donald did not the other day.
All right, we understand our picture has been corrected, so Brian Nielsen is in the red, Roberto Bolatto of Cuba in the blue, and Bolatto looking to measure on Nielsen. This is round one. On Tuesday, Bolatto defeated Larry Donald of the United States 10-4. And Nielsen over Peter Hrivnak 14-4. Nielsen, who joined the Danish Army in 1985 to lose weight. He was 315 pounds. Joined the army, now he's down to a slim 235, but it's Roberto Bolatto with the slim pickings right now, just teeing off on Nielsen. I kind of had a feeling this might be a mismatch.
Well, I'll tell you what, Nielsen's got a pretty good chin though, and I know he's gonna try very hard to win this fight.
Nielsen, a character. Likes to look up to the stands to all his friends who cheer his name during the day and gesture toward them.
Oh, Bolatto just beat him clean to the punch with that right hand.
Roberto Bolatto of Cuba, the reigning world champion in the super heavyweight division. This is the best I have seen Bolatto look in these Olympic Games in over a year.
Well, you know, he's about 7 or 8 pounds lighter than he had been when the Americans fought the Cubans at the World Championship Challenge in Tampa back in February. And I think a lot of the U.S. guys were very, very surprised at the Roberto Bolatto that showed up here.
Well, Brian Nielsen wears tattoos, but he has been tattooed by Roberto Bolatto here in this first round.
He now has a matching tattoo on his face.
That is the end of round one. An easy round for Roberto Bolatto. 5-0 the score.
There you get a look at the 23-year-old Bolatto, sparred with Teofilo Stevenson. Began boxing 9 years ago.
Both of these super heavyweights using the George Foreman approach, not sitting in the corner.
There you see the tattoos of Nielsen. There's a Viking head on his right arm with his name in it. And on his left arm, there is a ship with his mom's name stenciled in.
Well, if his mom's name is Mom.
And higher on the sail on that left arm is Kawa for the motorcycle Kawasaki he likes to ride. His mother is not pleased with the fact that her name is tattooed into her son's arm. Not pleased at all. But
why not?
She hates tattoos.
What greater love could a man show?
Well, he does not have his girlfriend Pia's name tattooed in. Guess he'll wait for the wedding.
That's always a good policy. Very painful to remove a tattoo.
We begin round number two. Roberto Bellotto of Cuba in the blue, controlling Brian Nielsen of Denmark. Nielsen, 27 years of age. And this bizarre day started with live coverage of the United States' Tim Austin being stopped at 104 of round number one against Raul Gonzalez of Cuba. Austin apparently thumbed in the eye, but it appeared he had no fight in him. A bizarre ending to the Olympic run of Tim Austin. Mulatto with the good foot movement. He is the lone Cuban fighter who has a distinct look, much more rounded, not as muscular, but very powerful.
You know, when you put him and Felix Savón side to side, you would swear that Felix is the heavier man.
Super heavyweights. Must be more than 201 pounds. And right now, Bellotto making Nielsen miss and then paying for it. There's that overhand right. Good combination.
Whoa, very slick move.
And right now, Nielsen can't even corner Bellotto, and Bellotto's having fun.
He's just playing games right now. He's trying out a few things he hasn't used for a while. He might even have the feeling that he can't knock out Nielsen because Nielsen has really soaked up some tremendous punches.
Nielsen tried to hit him on the top of the head and tap him, but Bellotto fired off a bunch of shots to the body. Nielsen is just a character. He's been fun to watch.
He's gone a long way. I mean, this man.
Oh, look at that! I told you, he's. Hey, Brian Nielsen has brought some personality to these games.
More importantly than that, would you ever think that this man would win a bronze medal in the Olympics?
Okay, we've been talking about the controversies with Torsten Mai and the cut he sustained. It's very bloody, but it happened against Montel Griffin on Tuesday night. There was a bad cut over the right eye, Wally. That very bad cut. The Cuban doctor looked at the cut, allowed the fight to continue. And it was a very bad cut.
It was a tremendous surprise that he did allow it to continue, but you never know. Some doctors are very gun-shy and stop fights with cuts like that, and others allow them to go on.
Now, Dr. Bob Voy of the United States was removed from looking at cuts, and a German doctor was put in charge. The question, would my fight today, according to the Olympic rule book, no dressing is allowed on a cut, and there is the black patch, the dressing, on the eye of my, and why?
Well, we hope Ferdy's finding that out, but boy, that just looks like some tar they scraped up off the road and smeared over his eyebrow.
Well, the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco, is roaming the hallways of the Juventude Pavilion trying to find out why Mai
was able to fight on, and Roberto Bellotto with an 8-0 lead.
He wanted to know why Mai's eye stayed dry.
Wow, you are, yeah, that's why you are a writer. And
that
a fine one indeed. Roberto Bellotto having fun with Brian Nielsen, an 8-0 lead to start this third round. Nielsen, though, has taken it well.
Yes, he has. He's taken it too well, I think, for Bellotto's taste. That's why Bellotto is just kind of dancing around, playing games.
Oh, and a warning. A
no.
warning. A standing,
a standing
eight count.
A standing 8 count. For what?
For what? And we look to the Cuban coaches behind us, and they just say, how does a guy get a standing 8 count for not getting hit? But we should remind the fans, and this may have made Bellotto mad, that most of the time, I would say about 40% of the time during the games, when a standing 8 count is being administered to, as the shuffle comes from Bellotto, the judges don't score a point anyway. And there's a perfect example.
Well, they probably, yes, it is a perfect example, but I bet you they scored a point for that one. There's the two bemused Cuban coaches.
The only one who's not taking this well is Tomislav Popek, the referee.
He doesn't think this is funny for some reason.
Well, Osvaldo Baseball didn't like that Montel Griffin was happy that he had cut his opponent, and he took that into account against Griffin and found a warning for a low blow, for a headbutt. Look at the headbutt by Nielsen.
Little headlock with it.
Hey, Nielsen looks like a pretty good sport, though.
Yes, he does.
I guess he has to realize he did do some showboating in his wins against Rivnak in the last round, and also against Sung Jung of Korea. Ooh, Brian Nielsen, a little feisty.
This kind of reminds me of Tony Galento against Joe Lewis. I feel like Nielsen knows he really can't win the fight, but he's going to give it his best shot, try to enjoy himself while he's in there.
Under a minute to go in this fight. Brian Nielsen. A breath of fresh air in these games in the red from Denmark against the world champion Roberto Bellotto. Look at that right hand. Boy, Nielsen can take a point. Look at him.
Oh.
Takes another right hand. Yeah.
That's, wow.
That's for his friends. And look at referee Popek. Yeah, that's it. Give him another caution. These referees refuse to allow anything to be entertaining. Neither fighter is mad. The fans are enjoying it.
Well, you know,
Popek has an attitude.
You know, one thing we should point out, Brian Nielsen has fought Bellotto a lot tougher and a lot more determinedly than Larry Donald did the other day.
Well, no question.
With a lot less talent.
Look at Nielsen.
Good for him.
He landed the last punch. And a standing ovation for Brian Nielsen.
That might be the most remarkable thing I've seen yet in this Olympic boxing.
Oh, it was entertaining.
Absolutely.
It was fun. Two guys competing. Nielsen was overmatched. He fought hard.
He's kind of like the average guy just going in there against the world champion, and he goes the distance.
He didn't mind the showboating. Cuban now with 9 fighters who advanced through the semifinals. He took it well. He showboated. The only person who had no tolerance for it was the referee.
For a minute there, Bellotto didn't know if that was a joke or not.
And Felix Simon waves the Cuban flag. They have a chance to reel in 9 gold medals, 9-0 in the semifinals. 5 will fight tomorrow, 4 on Sunday. Look at the finish. Nielsen, a good sport.
I'll tell you what, I want him on my side if I'm ever in a bar fight in the Netherlands.
And I think referee Popek was overmatched by the two competitors, and he kind of typified what this Olympic competition has been like with the